This is a journey of how a single sperm cell fertilizes an egg to form a baby. It all begins with a sperm and an egg. When a couple engage in an unprotected sexual intercourse, about 20 to 150 million sperm cells are ejaculated into the vagina of the woman. The millions of sperm cells swim in this race to fertilize the egg which has been released from one of the ovaries during ovulation. In the vagina, some of these sperms give up on this journey, either due to abnormal shapes like two tails or two heads, or due to the fact that they are slow swimmers or just too weak. However, only one lucky and fastest sperm can fertilize the egg. The surviving millions of sperm continue to swim in their numbers towards the cervix. Cervical mucus, which is wet and slippery at this point, makes it easy for the sperm to swim to meet the egg. In the uterus, the immune system of the woman, half of the sperm cells swim into the fallopian tube, where the unfertilized egg awaits, while the other half swim into the other empty fallopian tube in search of the egg. This immune response is the body's way of preventing polyspermy, which is basically a condition where an egg is fertilized by more than one sperm. While in the fallopian tube, the sperm cells undergo some physical and chemical changes known as capacitation. This process leads to changes in the sperm's pattern of movement, making them to have a more vigorous non-linear motion to swim more effectively towards the egg. This process of capacitation also causes changes to the composition of its membrane so that the sperm can be able to fuse with the egg and carry out an acrosome reaction. However, only a few hundred of sperm cells eventually get to the egg on this journey. The egg has two protective layers, and only one hyperactive sperm can burrow through the first layer, known as the corona radiata, to get to the second protective layer, known as the zona pellucida. To pass through this thick layer, the sperm binds to the receptors on the zona pellucida and undergoes an acrosome reaction, where it releases enzymes that helps it penetrate this layer. Once it has penetrated the zona pellucida, the tail of the sperm detaches and the surface of the egg undergoes a chemical change and forms a barrier that prevents other sperms from entering. Finally, we have a winner, the luckiest and strongest sperm, I would say. Once the sperm and the egg unite and fertilization occurs, a zygote is formed, which contains 46 chromosomes, 23 from each of the biological parents, that is, 23 chromosomes from the man and the other 23 chromosomes from the woman. These chromosomes help to determine the baby's gender and physical traits like the eye color, hair color, and other characteristics. The zygote then travels through the fallopian tube down towards the uterus within 5 days and begins to divide to form a cluster of cells known as the morula. This basically looks like a tiny raspberry in appearance. Around the 4th week, once the morula reaches the uterus, it becomes what is known as a blastocyst, and about 6 days after fertilization, this begins to burrow into the uterine lining in a process known as implantation. Within the blastocyst, the inner layer of cells will become the embryo, while the outer layer gives rise to the part of the placenta which provides nutrients and oxygen to the baby throughout pregnancy. Around the sixth week of pregnancy, the brain and spinal cord develop. The heart and other organs start to form. At the seventh week, the face continues to grow and the nostrils become visible. This development continues, and after 9 months, the baby is born and a new life emerges.